Hey guys, in this video, I want to talk to you about how Mucuna-Prions can specifically benefit men's health. Mucuna-Prions, also known as velvet bean or the magic bean, is a popular herb in Ayurvedic medicine, where it has been used for thousands of years as an aphrodisiac, a fertility boosting tonic, a sexual tonic, an herb that is used to treat depression and other mental and mood imbalances, one that is used to increase energy, decrease stress, and has even been clinically proven to not only do all of these things, but also be protective against things like Parkinson's and many other degenerative issues. Now there's many benefits of Mucuna-Prions. I've talked about them previously in past videos, but in this particular video, I want to focus on how Mucuna can specifically benefit men's health. So there's three primary mechanisms to Mucuna that gives it most of its medicinal benefits. And those are the ability to first and foremost boost dopamine production. Mucuna contains L-DOPA, which is a precursor to dopamine production. The second major thing that Mucuna is known and clinically proven to do is lower prolactin. Prolactin is a pituitary stress hormone that is most elevated after pregnancy for the purposes of producing breast milk. However, it produces breast milk at the expense of your bone health. So prolactin can actually mobilize calcium from your bones to produce breast milk, which can lead to an increased risk of osteoporosis, tooth decay. Not to mention, prolactin is part of the stress hormone system and can lead to many stress responses or stress reactions in the body, and is implicated in tons of health issues that we've talked about previously. The third major thing that Mucuna is known to do is actually lower cortisol. So cortisol is a more well-known stress hormone, unlike prolactin, and it is the classic stress hormone secreted by the adrenal glands when the thyroid function is low, when we're chronically stressed, if we have a progesterone deficiency, or if we just don't have enough energy to cope with stress healthfully. And although cortisol is a helpful survival, emergency-like hormone, it can deteriorate the health of the body. It can directly catabolize the tissues throughout the body. It can lead to accelerated aging of the skin. It can lead to leaky gut by catabolizing the intestinal tissue. It can weaken the immune system by atrophying the thymus gland. And it can even contribute to things like diabetes because it can impair our cells' ability to oxidize glucose and many other things. In taking a look at these three modes of action, I want to talk to you about how accomplishing these things can improve men's health in particular. So getting right into it, one of the major things that all of these mechanisms can do positively for men's health is improve sexual health, fertility health, and libido. So looking first and foremost at dopamine. Dopamine actually has a beneficial effect on libido. In fact, dopamine is one of the major neurochemicals responsible for your libido and your sex drive. So when dopamine is high, you have a healthy libido, a healthy sex drive, and a sense of pleasure for sex or a healthy appetite for sex, and usually experience pleasure during sex. And on the opposite end, when dopamine is low, usually you don't have a libido, you have a low sex drive, no appetite for sex, and if you have it, it's usually not even that enjoyable or pleasurable. So high dopamine means strong sex drive, low dopamine means low sex drive. Not to mention that dopamine is a precursor to testosterone production. It plays a role in testosterone synthesis. So usually if dopamine is low, testosterone is low. And because testosterone has a major impact on your sperm quality and sperm health, low testosterone could lead to fertility issues as well. In fact, it's actually been documented in three different clinical studies. Looking at one study in a group of 60 men, it was found that when people took 5 grams of Mucuna daily, that their sperm quality, motility, and volume increased. And in two other studies on over 250 men, they found that not only did sperm quality overall increase, but so did their testosterone levels. And just adding to this picture here, keep in mind that both prolactin and cortisol are major antagonists to healthy sex steroid production. So prolactin and cortisol can directly interfere with the functioning of the testes, leading to poor sperm quality, low testosterone production, and can interfere with both your sex drive and your fertility health. So through its dopamine boosting effects, its ability to lower cortisol and prolactin, Mucuna has a very profound effect on improving overall sexual health, sexual function, and your sex drive. Now, in addition to improving libido and fertility health, Mucuna may also be beneficial for people suffering from erectile dysfunction. So erectile dysfunction is known to be driven by prolactin. There's a strong correlation between hyperprolactinemia and erectile dysfunction. And this goes back to that statement I made earlier, that prolactin can actually interfere with the function of your testes, leading to low testosterone production. And testosterone has a very direct impact on the smooth muscle in the penile shaft. So low testosterone and high prolactin is often implicated in erectile dysfunction. And we know Mucuna actually can target both aspects here. It can actually lower prolactin and boost testosterone, making it a novel herb for anybody experiencing erectile dysfunction. Moving along, another major benefit that Mucuna Prehens could have in regards to men's health is its ability to protect the prostate and improve prostate health. So as I've talked about in many videos here on the YouTube channel, prostate cancer, prostate enlargement, prostate inflammation is not caused by testosterone. Despite misinformation, I've actually shown studies that have proven that injecting bioidentical dihydrotestosterone or DHT alongside vitamin D supplementation can actually reverse prostate cancer. So it's not testosterone that drives prostate cancer. It's usually estrogen and prolactin that drive most cancers due to their general interference with cellular energy metabolism. So anything that chronically interferes with a cell's ability to make energy can lead to mutations, cell damage, and ultimately cancer cell proliferation. However, there's also clear evidence that shows that hyperprolactinemia or high prolactin and estrogen are contributing factors to prostate cancer. And actually, most people with prostate issues have low levels of testosterone. What's interesting is that we've all been told that testosterone declines with age, yet prostate cancer is always found in older men when testosterone is at its lowest. So how would it be the driving force of prostate cancer? But we do know that on the opposite end, estrogen and prolactin and other stress hormones rise with age. So if that's not common sense enough, at least take a look at some of these studies that show the correlation between estrogen, prolactin, and prostate cancer. Now, inserting Mucuna, we've discovered here that Mucuna does lower prolactin efficiently and effectively, making it a novel therapy, or at least a worthwhile therapy to implement for protecting yourself from prostate enlargement, prostate cancer, and potentially even working as a therapy to correct it. Now, while we're on the topic of prolactin, let's just look at a couple more health issues in regards to men's health that are related to high prolactin levels. So a couple of the common health conditions that men tend to experience more than women that are related to high prolactin, first and foremost, diabetes. High prolactin is definitely implicated in diabetes and a contributing factor. Another one is going to be hair loss or the so-called androgenic alopecia or male pattern baldness. I've talked about this many times on the YouTube channel about how it contributes to hair loss and its correlation to hair loss and the so-called androgenic alopecia, largely due to its effect on thyroid function. So prolactin tends to oppose the function of the thyroid. And when the thyroid's low, keep in mind the thyroid is the major hormone responsible for regulating hair growth and the hair growth cycle. And if that's interfered with, this can lead to any sort of hair loss imaginable. And other men's health issues driven by prolactin are the ones we already covered, usually erectile dysfunction, a loss of libido, low sex drive, infertility, low testosterone, etc. Fortunately, Mucuna Prehens' ability to lower prolactin could be therapeutic for all of these conditions. So that's it for this video. There are, of course, many other benefits that Mucuna Prehens can provide, but most of them are universal. So they apply to both men and women pretty equally. So I just wanted to try to cover the more male dominant or men's health related health conditions that Mucuna could be beneficial for. If there are other men's health related conditions that I didn't cover in this video and you're wondering if Mucuna can help with those, just leave those in the comment section below and I'll be sure to answer them and give you a clear picture as to whether or not Mucuna may be beneficial or what else you might be able to do about it. Otherwise, that does bring this video to a close. If you've enjoyed it, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the YouTube channel for more videos like this if you haven't yet already. And of course, if you're interested in learning more about Mucuna, all of the various clinically proven benefits, how to dose it, etc., you can find that on our online tonic herb shop in the description box below.